So let's say that we were to look at the Laplace transform. Okay, which one did I want to do here? Doesn't really matter, I guess. Let's say you want to do sine of t, u of t minus pi over 2. I could do the same thing. I could say the sine of t minus pi over 2 plus pi over 2, right? But then I have to use the addition formula for sine, right? Which isn't bad. I mean, I could do that. If you know it, that's great. But there's an easier way of doing it if you just kind of think about it. Here's what I do, though. When I look at this, I think I'm going to, again, you know, this is very short, right? This has to be this. But we're going to be shifting t by pi over 2, right? Now remember, when you shift by 90 degrees, you end up with a cofunction. That's why it's called a cofunction, to shift at 90 degrees. This is why sine is called cosine when you shift at 90 degrees. Because here is you're going to get cosine of t minus pi over 2 times u of t minus pi over 2. Okay? Now, one thing you have to be very careful about, they're not always exactly equal, depending on which way you shift it. Sometimes they end up being a negative. Now, what I do, is I just want to think about base graphs. So when I think about what I have here, we have sine, right? Sine is like this. Okay. This has to be the same as this. I can't change anything, right? It's like back here, I didn't really change anything. So I had either 2t minus 14 plus 14, which is either 2t, right? So let's think about it. Cosine would normally start here and do this, right? If I shift the pi over 2 to the right, it's actually going to be here, and it's going to be right on top of that, right? So you can see it actually is the same sign, and I don't have to change anything. But you usually do. Now, sometimes it'll end up being the opposite. So the graph may do something like this. You have to put a negative. Okay, I don't memorize that. That's how with the base graph and shift, and then I make the appropriate choice. The other option, of course, is if you want to do this, is you do the use of, you know, the identity is this, right? The sine of t minus pi over 2 cosine of pi over 2 plus sine of pi over 2 cosine of t minus pi over 2. That's the identity, if you remember. This is equal to 0. This is equal to 1 if you cosine of t minus pi over 2, which is what we got here, right? So that's the one you have to be careful with, because it does change, right? From sine to cosine if you shift it. But that's the same idea. So if I'm going to do the u, you get negative pi over 2s, right? And I'm going to focus on my function then. Cosine of t is s over s squared plus 1.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.